Hey, it's Katrina Sawa here, the Jumpstart Your Biz Coach with jumpstartyourbiznow.com and Jumpstart Publishing, where we help you get your book done. Hey, I wanted to talk to you today about speaking. Are you speaking to grow your business? Are you speaking to get clients? Are you speaking to get leads to follow up on so that they can eventually become clients or buy your programs, products, and services? If not, you really want to. Speaking is like the fastest path to cash. When you are the expert in front of the room, the Zoom room or the in-person room, everybody looks to you for advice on whatever it is, the topic that you're talking on. And so I highly recommend getting more comfortable with speaking. If that's a fear for you, or you just aren't sure how to get speaking gigs or what to speak about, that is the easy part. Okay. And I love to help people with that. In fact, I have a speaker training that's already online, and you can go get it if you want to at jumpstartyourbiznow.com/trainings. There's a speaker training there. There's a couple, actually. There's one that's like a beginner for like authentically speaking, and that's like $27. So seriously, if you want to get some support, start there. If you really want to dive in and do the whole training, it's, you know, like $1,000. So, but it's totally worth it. And if you buy that, I can, you know, email me and I'll even do a call with you. But what I wanted to talk today about is one of the things I see as a speaker booker. So I book speakers for my International Speaker Network webinars. I run a group. It's a free group, by the way. You should join. It's called the International Speaker Network. And the website for that is speakernetwork.com. You can go there, sign up for free, get access to the previous recordings, as well as find out when the upcoming calls are. But what I wanted to talk about was the fact that when people apply to speak at that meeting or any meeting, you have to have, first of all, you have to know your audience. Because I get a lot of people who sign up to apply to speak, but they're not the best fit for the audience. And they clearly don't read the page where I say what the audience is and what I'm looking for as a speaker. And they sign up anyways, because they're not paying attention. So the first key is to pay attention to who the audience is or the group is where you want to speak. You have to tailor sometimes your talk to fit that audience. So for example, one of my talks is the 8 secrets to a consistent money-making business. I could do that talk though for people in careers who don't have their own business. And I could say 8 secrets to a more fulfilling life, or to a more successful and fulfilling life, or something like that. Excuse me. I could totally tailor those 8 secrets slightly. I probably would come up with like 3 or something like that. But the point is that you don't just take your signature talk and put it on and apply it to every single group you're going to speak at, but you need to think about the group. Number one, you need to think about what they're looking for, what their problems are. What are the biggest problems with that market of people, the majority of the people who are going to be there? In fact, if someone asks, a lot of times people ask me to speak and they say, well, can you speak? What's your topic? And I say, well, I have many topics to choose from. What's your audience? Who's your audience and what do they care about? Or what's their biggest need or challenge right now? And then I will tailor a talk to fit that if I don't already have one. Okay. The second thing to do is to come up with a really exciting, juicy, hooky talk title. So the title of your talk is so critical. Now, when you're going into corporate and you're speaking to corporate audiences or larger conferences where there's, you know, corporate people, they like smaller, not so hooky topic titles, frankly. They like succinct, like leadership 101 or something like that, right? Which is a buzzword, leadership is, by the way. But in the entrepreneur world, we like really cool sayings. Like I have one that's how to make fast cash with easy yes offers, right? I've seen a bunch of them. I don't have time to go into all the examples, but if you go to that ispeakernetwork.com webpage, you'll see the previous webinars and you can look at some of the talk titles in there. They're not all perfect, but excuse me, my chair keeps going down on me. So the talk title is really key. Then what you want to think about is, okay, what what am I going to teach? What am I going to teach in this talk? And you have to be able to scale your content. So you have to be able to scale it to fit a 1 hour, which is ideal, 1 hour or 90 minute talk, right? So you might add more stories. You might add a little bit more depth in your content. You might also increase the time of your introduction and or your close. So a talk is kind of like an essay back in high school, right? Where you have the intro, the body content, and the close. And so you want to think of it in terms of that. You don't want to transition it so abruptly like I'm talking about, but you want to think about that. So you want to look at your close first and then your content and then your intro. Frankly, that's backwards, I know, but that's how we build our talks. And so I wanted to share that. So the bullet points can change depending on how long your talk is. So what you don't want to do is you don't want to have too much content for your talk time. Right now, the trend is about a 20-minute talk, 15 to 20-minute talk. And that's very common in the entrepreneur world. And in fact, the TED Talks are 18 minutes, something like that. So you want to ideally design your talk for that. You want to know what to put in it to add it to make it longer and what you can even take out of that time talk to make it a 5 or 10 minute talk. Like for example, this morning I have a 1 hour webinar, which is technically the whole webinar is an hour. So I probably have about 45 minutes to do the webinar the presentation, right? Because there's not a lot of other stuff going on during this particular talk. Tonight though, I'm speaking on a big conference, it's virtual, and I have a 10 minute talk. That's it. That's all I can do. So I want to share one main point, one story, one takeaway. I don't want to share my 8 secrets to a consistent money-making business in 10 minutes because I'll be like, blah, 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 and nobody will get anything out of the talk, right? So I have to be very strategic on what I include. So I'm just trying to give you some ideas. When you are clear on what you are speaking about and the content you're providing and the title and who it's for and all that stuff, when you're clear on that, you have more confidence to go book yourself. You do, I promise you will. I promise. The reason you don't have more confidence right now is probably because you don't have clarity on what you're speaking about or who it's to or where to find speaking gigs. So really getting the clarity on who it's for, what you're doing, how it's going to benefit you as well. Like, are you doing a talk that's designed to sell into a program, training, or offer, right? Whether you can sell from that talk or not, a lot of times people say, oh, you can't sell, but you can offer something for free. Okay, great. You know, so there's all kinds of strategies on what to do for free in that case, but you still have to do that talk with the goal in mind that people are going to want to buy from you. They're going to want to learn more about whatever it is you're speaking on. So you can't give them everything. You do have to give them good amount of nuggets, right? During the time allotted, but don't give them too much. I tell you, most people who are starting out as a speaker always want to put too much content into their talk. Always. I've done it for years. I did it. Oh my God. I'm constantly pulling things out of my talks to keep it simpler, to also have more time to really engage the audience. Because if you don't engage the audience and you don't you know, in person, you would touch people or you would, you know, call them out or have them raise their hand. On virtual, you can still do some of the same things. You could say, oh, I see you over there, right? You could have them, hey, raise your hand, put something in the chat. You can get them engaged. But if you don't get them engaged, they won't buy into you like trust and connect wise, in which case they won't probably come and do some kind of follow-up or buy from you. So this is just a little, you know, I had it on my brain today to share and I wanted to bring this up. So if you have questions, again, there's free stuff on my free trainings page. There's paid trainings online. You can come and talk to me about coaching all this. I also have a live event coming up in October where we do teach the speaking because it's the number one marketing strategy I teach. So you can come to the event in October. It's a small group. We really focus on a lot of different things to grow your business. And you can find that at jumpstartevents.net. Jumpstartevents.net. You will find any of the events coming up. And that is actually a great bang for your buck because you usually get me for 3 days working on your business on a lot of different things, not just speaking. So I hope to see you soon and have a good day, everyone.